So I didn't know. I knew hers was packaged in China by the because it said it on the box. Mm-hmm. But I didn't know if she was sourcing this from China.
Okay.
So of course, you know, you could get on Alibaba or whatever. And I'm like, well, let me just see if anybody over there is producing this brush. Mm-hmm. And maybe she's private labeling it.
Right.
From someone who's actually manufacturing it over there, but, you know, putting her logo on it. So I could never find the brush on, I could never find the brush on Alibaba. So I'm like, okay, well, maybe she's, she must be getting it from the United States. But I just really couldn't wrap my mind around why there was so many issues with keeping inventory or keeping stock.
Hey guys, this is Garrett and Ceata with Eye to Eye, Idea to Invention.
From.
Yes. Eye to Eye, Idea to Invention. And we are here on this glorious Tuesday here to talk about what we have put out into the atmosphere, this new great product that we are bringing to the masses called TangleMaster. That was pretty good. TangleMaster.
Get some tangles right out of that.
So it's been a long time waiting, long time coming, and we're pretty much finally here.
Right. So we're gonna talk about the whole, like, how the brush came about, what gave us the idea. All of that.
The journey.
The journey. You call it the journey.
Yes.
So it all started when Levita, our stylist, my stylist, she's also Puff Cuff's official stylist, and she is out of Coiled, a textured salon in Schenectady. I'm just glad I can say that word.
Schenectady, New York.
Schenectady, New York. So we were at a convention together, and she was like, I brought you something. And she brought me this. She was like, have you heard of the Felicia Leatherwood brush? And I was like, no. She said, it's a detangler brush, and it's like the best brush I've ever used. And she was like, I just wanted to give you one. So this is the one that she gave me. So I had never used it before. I'd never seen it before. And I was like, wow, this is an interesting concept. How the bristles are, you know, they flex, they fan out. It's usually a little bit more flexible than this, but they fan out this way, and they can go up and down. Can you see that? And then the tines are spaced. They're like, what do you call it? Staggered.
Yes.
Yeah. So they're staggered teeth. So the teeth are not lined up right next to each other. They're they kind of like move. They're positioned up and down. So when I used it the first time, I was like, oh my God, this is magic.
Yeah.
This is the best detangling brush I have ever used. And anybody that has curly hair literally is like, the detangling time, especially the tighter your curl or coil or kink is, whatever you want to label it,
yeah,
the tighter it is, the longer it takes to detangle.
Right.
And usually I could spend, hours in the shower trying to detangle, pruning up, itching, all that, trying to get done with my hair. So this was like, it totally speeded up the process. So I was like, we should carry this brush.
Yeah.
So I think it was right around the holiday season, and that's when we could usually come up with our toolbox that we offered previous years. Either last year or the year before.
Holidays of 17 or 18.
Right, 17 or 18, whatever it was. We offer a toolbox, and toolbox is a
subscription kind of thing.
No.
Not even that.
No.
No.
It is just a customized gift set.
Yep.
So we always try to source products from either black girl vendors or female vendors to end up being as part of the toolbox. It's called the Lux Toolbox, and we used to offer it at every Christmas. It's coming. But it's not coming back this Christmas. Come back next year. But anyway, so I wanted to include the Felicia Leatherwood brush in the box.
Yeah.
But at that time, went to her website to try and get it. It was sold out. Mm-hmm. And there was no like, it wasn't like an estimated time of when she was going to get more. So I was like, oh, okay. So then, but when I was researching it, when I researched the Felicia Leatherwood brush, this other brush came up at the same time, which was this brush, which I'm like, wow, that is almost the same brush. So this brush here is called, I don't know what it is even called, if it's even called a name. Mm-hmm. So it's an equine brush. So this is a brush that horse trainers and horse owners use to detangle the mane,
okay,
or the tail of the horse.
Okay.
So I saw different videos of people using this exact brush, and I'm like, wow, that makes total sense. So, you know, if you got horse mane that you can detangle, we should be able to detangle, you know, right, human hair with this. So then I saw this brush and I saw videos on how to use it. And I was like, well, let me see if I can order this brush because I couldn't get hers. So I found a website, ordered the brush, and had given it to a couple of my friends and family. Mm-hmm. And then also as a bonus, an unannounced bonus,
yeah,
we put some of these brushes in the toolboxes that they ordered last whatever year. Mm-hmm. And we put a little sign on it and said, just tell us, you know, this is a free gift for you, let us know what you think of, yeah, this brush.
Yeah.
So we did that, and you know, and we had, I think we sold maybe about 20 or 30 toolboxes. So 20 or 30 people,
yeah,
got the brush.
Yeah.
And they emailed back to say whether yay or nay.
Mm-hmm.
I would say 90% of the people were like, this brush is amazing.
Yeah.
So again, I'm like, okay, so it's a proven brush. And like I said, I had not had the Felicia Leatherwood brush very long. I knew it worked for me, but I didn't know, you know, what,
right,
if there was, you know, what the buzz was with everyone, yeah, else. And so, yeah, and we had like a random group. So, yeah, I was like, this should be getting to people with all different types of hair texture. Let's just see if it works.
Mm-hmm.
So they received this and they all loved it.
Okay.
And literally, I think it was only one email that they were like, it didn't do so great on my hair. You know, there's only like one or two that was maybe, right, negative. So again, we were like, okay, we need to carry this brush. So I didn't want to offer the horse brush because literally the quality of this horse brush is like a, you know, dollar store, mm-hmm, dollar tree brush. It's just, it does the job, but the quality of it isn't that great.
Okay.
So went back to try and get the brush again from Felicia Leatherwood, but again, her brush was out of stock. Or she didn't know when she was going to be able to get in. So I was like, okay. So went to my manufacturer and I'm like, look, I really want to offer this brush. What can we do?
Mm-hmm.
Because the brush works. It is a great detangling brush. But I want to be able to know that I can consistently offer this brush to my customers if I introduce it to them.
Right.
And he was like, Ceata, we can make our own brush. I'm like, for real? You know, I'm thinking all brushes have to be made in China. I've never seen a brush that's made in the United States.
Right.
So he was like, yeah, this is not anything that's difficult. We can just make the brush ourselves. And I'm like, well, wow, that would solve not only my problem, that would probably solve her problem. Because I could see when I ordered the brush, not when I ordered, when I was given the brush, that, and I think I did place an order. I can't remember.
A wholesale order?
No, I never could place a wholesale order because they were like, you could place it, but we don't know when we're going to get it. It was, okay, always something like not guaranteed that we were going to be able to get, yeah, the product when we needed the product.
Yeah.
And I didn't want to get the product and then offer once and then not be able to offer it again.
Mm-hmm.
So made me lose my train of thought. Where was I at?
Well, no, you were talking to the manufacturer.
I was talking to the manufacturer.
And you're like, oh, we can make our own.
Right. He said, we can make our own. We can make it here in the United States. Oh, that's what it was. Because when I got her brush, I could see that it was made in China.
Mm-hmm.
From the packaging, I could tell that it was made in China. And then when I took the brush to our manufacturer, he was like, yeah, this is made in China. I can tell by, you know, he's had over 25 years in the plastic industry, you know, plastic injection molding industry. So he was like, I'm pretty sure this is made in China. So anyway, and because of other people that we have known in the accessory industry, majority of hair access, plastic tools and hair accessories, I would say 99.9% of them are made in China.
Right.
And that's, you know, that's a whole nother video.
Video session.
On Americans getting their products made in China. So anyway, when he said we could do it, I was like, cool, let's do it.
Yes.
Because not only can we, you know, guarantee that we'll be able to continue to get the brush when mm-hmm. we want it, get whatever, you know, inventory on a consistent basis and be able to offer it to our customers, we need to have it made in the United States. Plus, I was like, maybe then we can go into a collaboration or a partnership right. with her, and then we could produce the brush for her.
Right.
So I thought I was coming from a great place. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But what ended up, what happened was, so anyway, we ended up, just ironically, another one of those God moments.
Mm-hmm.
We did that whole show about being in Paris and being at the Natural Hair Academy in Paris this past June. So guess who one of the headliner speakers was?
Who?
Felicia Leatherwood.
What?
But I should also start to say, Felicia Leatherwood and I first came into contact with each other via Instagram. Because y'all know I cyberstalk folks, not like, that's my part of my, I don't harass. I cyberstalk from afar. And then when that opportunity opens to connect, I'm connect. All about it.
Right.
On it.
Gotcha.
So I would say, Wee. I think this is 2015. We moved here in 2014.
2013.
Because we started the business in 2013 and we were in Illinois. Yeah, it was June 2014. June 2014, so we moved here and then, because Grayson had his third birthday here.
Yeah, okay, all right, so.
We got that right. It was warm, remember?
It was summertime, I know that for sure.
In Georgia, when is it not warm? It was warm. That's a big deal when you come from the north, because you can only up north you'd be like, it was warm, so it couldn't have been January.
Nowhere so to get
okay, when we come back, we will talk about when Felicia Leatherwood and I first came into each other's spectrum.
Okay. Gotcha.
Alrighty.
Cool. We'll see you all on the other side of this break. Hey y'all, it's Garrett and Ceata back here with Eye to Eye.
Ouch, I almost yanked out my thing.
Ideal to Invention. Don't yank out your earpiece.
Ouch.
Coming back to you, talk to you about
the TangleMaster and how it came about and all this.
Relationships and how everything has evolved. So you were saying, Ceata, when we left out that you're going back to when you first met Felicia.
Yes. So I had been cyberstalking Felicia Leatherwood mm-hmm. back in 2015 because I knew she was a natural, one of the few like celebrity level that was, you know, promoted as a celebrity level natural hairstylist. And I thought to myself, if I could get a puff cuff in her hands, I could see the different people that she were considered clientele, and they all were definitely candidates to use the puff cuff, and they all wore their hair up in a puff. So I can't remember if, I know it was probably all through DM, but I reached out to her to see if I could send her some puff cuffs to mm-hmm. see if she would be willing to use them on any of her clients. And she did. She ended up using it on Issa Rae
mm-hmm.
when Issa was doing, is she still doing Insecure?
Yeah.
It's still on?
I'm not sure if it's still on or not, to be honest with you.
Well, it was like one of the first or second seasons of Insecure. And Issa has very soft hair. Mm-hmm. So very soft, very fine hair. So the puff cuff would work for her because it wouldn't, if she wanted to wear a puff and wear her own hair, it wouldn't like take her hair and go whoop. You know, right, like a rubber band would. So I saw one of the episodes. I think I still have an image of and photo of it on my phone. So I saw the episode where Felicia used I think it was Puff Cuff Jr. in Issa's hair on one of her episodes of Insecure. And I was like, yay, the Puff Cuff's on TV. And then there's actually another actress that wore it on, she was Theo's first girlfriend.
Justine?
No. The first girlfriend.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Her name. Oh, shoot. I can't think of her name. But I met her at another show and I gave her a puff cuff. And she was on an episode. I want to say The Good Wife. She was on an episode of The Good Wife.
Okay.
And she tagged us and let us know that she was wearing her puff cuff. And then we've also had Slay, who is our ambassador. She's on the Allstate commercial, where it's a little girl that's growing up and she's a little black girl at different stages of her life watching her dad, and her dad is an Allstate agent or State Farm agent.
Yeah.
So we've been on, Puff Cuff's been on TV a couple times. But anyway, so Issa was one of the first ones to wear the Puff Cuff on TV. And I saw the episode, thought it was great, and you know, reached out to Felicia to say if she ever wants more, or if she's willing, I will send her as many puff cuffs as she wants.
Right.
And then that pretty much was kind of it.
Mm-hmm.
So when this brush came out, I had no idea that she had produced a brush. So like I said, when I found out about the brush and wanted to be able to carry it on the site, there was always an issue with the brush being out of stock.
Right.
So now we're gonna, is that fast forward or is that rewind?
Yep.
Okay. To now. Or to actually this past June.
Whatever you want it to be.
Right. So I had, like I said, we were in Paris at the Natural Hair Academy. We just happened to be in Paris because one of our twins was invited to play at the, he's in marching band, and his band was invited to play for the anniversary in Normandy for D-Day.
Yes.
So we went there for that, and it just happened to be the same weekend that one of the largest natural hair exhibitions, hair shows was happening in Paris also. So it was like really ironic. We're like, wow, you know, and then I had reached out to the coordinators of the show to ask if we could exhibit, but they were like, we're full right now, but we'll give you complimentary passes for you and your family. So we went, had a absolutely fabulous time, and hope to be there next year as an exhibitor and hopefully a headliner.
Hopefully.
I want a main stage.
We'll see.
But anyway, so Felicia was there.
Yeah.
And come to find out, just another blessing, we just happened to be, I'm a Expedia, Hotwire, Kayak kind of gal when it comes to hotel stays. So I just randomly picked a hotel based on the hotels.com reviews.
Yes.
Just happened so that was the host hotel for the coordinators and all of their celebrity guests.
Mm-hmm.
They were staying at the same hotel that I picked. I was like, Lord, won't he do it?
Won't he do it?
Yes. So we ended up seeing Felicia at the actual show because we went 2 days in a row. We went 2 days in a row. And we saw her there. And that was my first time actually physically seeing her in person.
Gotcha.
And I was like, yay, there's Felicia Leatherwood. Because I get very starstruck, like stupid starstruck, embarrassing starstruck.
Yeah.
And Garrett's like, okay, look, relax. Take a breath. So I did, and I went up to her, and I'm like, Felicia, I'm Puff Cuff, blah, blah, blah. And she's like, oh, yeah, I remember you. Yes, I used your Puff Cuff on Issa. I was like, yes, and I just want to say thank you so much. And by the way, I want to talk to you about your brush. And she was, you know, she was like, what? okay. And I said, you know, I know you have my number, and I think I have your number, and I think we're at the staying at the same hotel. Please get in touch with me because I want to talk to you about your brush. But she was in the midst of running because she had her booth and she had a main stage, so she was like super busy the whole time. So I was like, okay, but I knew we were staying at the same hotel, but you know, Paris ain't that big on whatever side of town we were. So I knew we would run across each other again. But basically, just never heard anything. I just figured she got busy, whatever, you know, whatever. So I didn't pursue anything else after that. I figured, you know, I figured, well, if it's meant to be, we'll eventually talk to each other.
Yeah.
So time went on, and we went ahead and started working on developing the brush. So one of the TangleMaster and the Felicia Leatherwood brush do not function any differently. They function exactly the same. They're both excellent at detangling, and I'm going to do a little video later, not right now because I'm on camera. I ain't doing it right now.
Yeah, don't but want to set the frog.
Right, don't that's a bathroom.
Right,
right. Yeah. On the cell phone camera. So, but as in terms of how they function exactly the same. But the only difference that I could see firsthand, and there was two things. One thing, I wanted to change how people use the brush. Second, I wanted to change the how the handle feels in your hand.
Yeah.
You want to say something?
Yeah, but I want to, before you go into the detailed differences between the two, I wanted to ask the question, why, if we can step back a couple steps and answer, why would your manufacturer say, well, we can make your own? Why? I mean, because...
Because we have... Excuse me. I don't know what that was.
I don't know either.
I didn't want it to be in the microphone, whatever it was. So,
our manufacturer always comes
from the standpoint of, why buy somebody else's when you can do it yourself?
And why can't we do it ourselves?
Well, I was asking. I wasn't even coming from the mindset, honestly, of
doing it ourselves.
I was thinking, okay, I know what it was. So I didn't know. I knew hers was packaged in China by the because it said it on the box. But I didn't know if she was sourcing this from China.
Okay.
So of course, you know, you could get on Alibaba or whatever, and I'm like, well, let me just see if anybody over there is producing this brush, and maybe she's private labeling it from someone who's actually manufacturing it over there, but you know, putting her logo on it. So I could never find the brush on, on Alibaba. So I'm like, okay, well, maybe she's, she must be getting it from the United States. But I just really couldn't wrap my mind around why there was so many issues with keeping inventory or keeping stock. So, and like I said, I've dealt with other, like some of our secondary ancillary, is that what you said?
Ancillary. Secondary, same thing. Go ahead.
Okay. But I want to use the vocabulary word. Ancillary
products. Yes.
We do source from overseas. But what ends up happening is it seems like overseas vendors, they can come and go like night and day.
Yeah.
So once you find a product that you love, you cannot necessarily 100% guarantee that come this time next year, you'll be able to get that same product from that particular manufacturer.
Yeah.
So I was like, I really don't want to deal with overseas. I really don't want to start to offer something, like I said before, and not be able to continue. Because I wanted this brush to be a staple in our arsenal. Because, I mean, when it comes to, we want Puff Cuff to be the one-stop shop for all tools for curly hair, curly textured hair. I don't want to just be like, okay, well, yeah, we had it last year, but we don't carry it anymore. So we want people to be able to get what they want to get when they want to get it. So with that, I was like, okay, I couldn't find it over there. Let me come to my manufacturer and say, you know, where can I get this? And he's like, what do you mean? We can make it. Let's just make it. And I'm like, cool, let's make it.
Right.
So we went ahead and started that process. Now, there is a big difference. Getting your tooling, which is actually the mold.
Yes.
Getting your tooling made in the United States versus getting your tooling made in China is like cost-wise, night and day.
Yeah.
You can have a tool in, you can get your tooling made in China
mm-hmm.
for almost 10%.
Of what you would do
of
here
what
in the
you would pay in the United States.
Yes.
So that's why a lot of small businesses, in all honesty, go overseas to get their tooling made or to get their products made because it's just that much cheaper. But
the problem with that is what?
The problem with that is exactly what was happening with the Felicia Leatherwood brush. You could not always guarantee that your stock would get here, or if that manufacturer might decide to close up shop one day, or that manufacturer might decide, you know what, I'm not going to give her the inventory, or give him or her the inventory on a regular basis. I'm going to make them. They kind of, you know, if something is really popular, you really cannot control and guarantee that you're going to be able to get your mm-hmm. items over here, because that manufacturer might just decide one day, you know what, I'm tired of doing business right. with you or whatever. God forbid that happens, but it's more of a possibility. And you have, how much can you control when your manufacturer is in a whole different country on the other side of the
right.
world?
Right.
Beyond the language barriers, and there's so many, due to the language barriers, there's so many go-between people that you have to deal with.
In order to get it done.
In order to get it done, which also, every time you have to deal with another person or another party,
yep.
that leaves more room for things to happen.
Mm-hmm. So is the equine brush patented, or is it?
Okay.
That's where my initial question was. How, what allows Puffcuff to
be
to
able to do
create
this?
It?
Okay. Well, actually what happens is this, the equine brush, the patent on this product is so old that it's now public domain.
On the equine brush.
On the equine brush.
Mm-hmm.
This patent has expired.
Okay.
So anybody can make this brush. Any guy can make a version of this brush. All of that. So that's why Felicia was able to make hers. So, you know, she just did a reiteration of this concept, which this concept, this concept and this design is public domain.
So, okay, so it's public domain and mm-hmm. it can't be repatented.
No, it cannot be repatented.
So,
no.
So what that means is that anybody, if they choose to want to have the capacity or the ability to make the brush,
right.
anyone can make the brush.
Anyone can make the brush.
Okay.
Right.
I just want to make sure that was understood, that anybody can make the brush, that it's not, there's no...
Say it again.
There's no stealing. There's no...
Say it again.
That anybody...
Say it again.
Anybody.
Anybody.
Anyone.
Anyone. Anybody.
Anybody.
Any person.
Anybody.
Any man.
Anybody.
Any girl.
Any
boy.
Yes.
Any person, ethnicity, anything. Make this brush. The only thing that's really the deal breaker...
Yeah.
Or the hardest thing, literally, is if you have the money to do it. In all honesty. Flat out.
Okay.
So, for instance, tooling in America, like all of our tools that we have had to build,
mm-hmm.
Which tooling is the mold, we have spent no less than $20,000 mm-hmm. on every tool.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just the mold itself.
Yeah.
And usually that mold has to be paid off before they'll actually make product for you.
Mm-hmm.
So, point blank, how many of us
have that?
Have just, you know, $20,000 to $30,000, and the more intricate the tool, I mean, the more intricate the product, the more expensive the tooling is going to be.
Yeah.
So we pretty much found out that the tooling for this was going to be between $35,000 to $40,000. So we were like, you know, because of what we've built with Puffcuff, we were fortunate enough to have the money to build the tool. So that's pretty much where it came from. It was like our manufacturer was like, look, I can get the tool designed, you guys can come up with the money for the tooling, we own and pop it.
Yeah.
So that's what happened.
Okay. All right.
So then we'll continue the conversation from Felicia, I need to talk to you about your brush.
All right. Sounds good.
All righty.
We'll talk to y'all on the other half.
name is Lexi, aka Lexi with the Curls, and I was one of the co-hosts today at Ditch the Band 2019, sponsored by the Puff Cuff. So I love the Puff Cuff because I can do quick little styles, and sometimes I just don't have enough time to actually fully do my hair, but this is like a whole style, and it literally took about 6 to 7 seconds. So you can get so many different looks out of it. So I love the Puff Cuff for the versatility and for the different styles that I can do. I would recommend the Puff Cuff for anyone that likes a good, easy hairstyle. So whether you have long hair, short hair, and I love that also, if I were to use a band, one, it could create a lot of damage. Also, you can't really get it to be big and puffy. So I like having my hair, like, I like it big. I want my puff to be big. And so this gives me that effect with that versus using like a rubber band.
Hey guys, this is Garrett and Ceata for Idea to Invention. And we're back to continue this conversation around the TangleMaster and how it came to be. And so we left the last segment talking about the last conversation that you had with Felicia.
Right. Which really, it didn't turn into anything.
Right.
We just never connected.
Mm-hmm. That was coming out of Paris.
That was coming out of Paris.
Okay.
That was coming out of Paris. So months later, we had already started the tooling. And then we got busy into Curl Fest and everything else. And then one day I saw, just time was passing and clicking off.
Yeah.
So one day I saw that I had a direct message on my phone from an Instagram from her. And she said, basically she remembered me saying something about her brush mm-hmm. in Paris and could we connect? And I was like, great, this is the opportunity for me to go ahead and tell her what,
right.
What's on our mind about what we would like to propose. Yeah. So did that, ended up having a conversation. She was actually calling because to ask advice on getting products made within the United States. Mm-hmm. And because she in fact was having difficulty with her manufacturer. And I told her, I was like, I figured that's what was probably happening because I could never get your stock.
Yeah.
So basically gave her the advice that we had to give about getting items made in the United States mm-hmm. and how you're able to control your inventory, control your whole supply chain basically.
Yeah.
But I also wanted to give her a proposal, and the proposal was that because we had already planned to make the brush,
yeah.
That we could private label her brush, and mm-hmm. I wanted to collaborate with her. So because she's already done a magnificent job
yeah.
of capturing the market and putting her name out there
yeah.
for, I mean, everybody knows this brush, not even as, it's called the Felicia Leather. The name of the brush is Brush with the Best.
Mm-hmm.
But no one calls it that. Literally, it's the Felicia Leatherwood brush.
Right.
So I was like, you've already put your name out there. You've already done such a great job on that. Let me private label your brush.
Yes.
So that way we could handle your, because we also have a fulfillment. We mm-hmm. do our own fulfillment.
Yes.
And we do our own distribution. So I said, I proposed that we could pay her a royalty on every brush sold, and we'll call it the Felicia Leatherwood Tangle Master brush.
Right.
So I offered to be able to pay her a royalty and then also be her manufacturer mm-hmm. and do fulfillment for her. So she wouldn't have the hiccups that she has been having.
Right.
Or at least I felt like that would remedy the hiccups that she's been having
yeah.
with getting her brush out there. And the conversation seemed to go well.
Yeah.
It went really, really well because I think I called you in on the mm-hmm. back half of it or something. So she was like, let me think about it and I'll get back with you. And so I told her, I said, well, what I'll do is I'll type up an email of everything that we're offering, because she could not only private label her brush, then we would also retail the brush on our website,
right.
but still pay her
right.
for every sale. Brush that we sold
so she could
under her name.
And royalty.
Right. So she would have got sales and royalty. And then she would have gotten, because I think, I'm not sure if she's doing her own fulfillment or not. I can't remember.
I don't believe she is.
I thought she was using somebody
here in Georgia. But either way.
Yes. Yes, she is.
Right?
That's a whole nother story.
That's a whole thing.
Yes.
And that was another
That was another
link.
Thing. That Right. Another link that we had together, because actually the company that she's using, we used to use at mm-hmm. one time.
Yeah.
So our thought process is you can bring everything in-house and have one-stop shop for everything. And that way you could come, you could see, you can control. And then because we've been doing this for 6 years, we can offer, you know, our, you know, services. And then, you know, because we've been fulfilling ourselves for at least 3 years.
Yeah.
So we could, you know, we could do that
for
her and have, she would have less worry about the whole process.
It'd be a value add for her.
Right. In the end, she turned us down. She said, no, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, you know, we're always open to hear your ideas. If you want to, you know, just because this is what we've written up doesn't mean that that's set in stone. If you want to, you know, come back with your thoughts on it.
Right.
We are open to hear whatever you want to say. But just know that come November, we are going to produce the brush. We're, the Puff Cuff is going to have a brush.
Right.
So, trying to think. I'm trying to think what happened. Oh, and then after that, I also let her know that because there's another brush that looks extremely similar to her brush.
Yeah.
That was coming from France.
Mm-hmm.
And I forget the name of that brush. Is it the Tangle Buster or something?
Yeah. Something like that.
Anyway, so it's coming from, basically it's coming from Alibaba. There is a brush on Alibaba that is very similar to all of these brushes, but they're all based on
the plastic.
That's the same brush, but it's not, what I saw was from
a different vendor.
But they are all sourcing their brush from Alibaba, basically.
Okay.
So our whole thing with one of our main philosophies within and company core, what do they call it? Core policies? Core
values.
Thank you, Isaac. It was hurting.
Right. He was like,
I
right
was
here.
Like, oh, right, right. One of our core values is to, if there's any possibility of having it made within the United States, that's what we're going to do
that's
first.
What we'll do. Yeah.
That's what we're going to do first,
mm-hmm.
especially when it comes to our core products.
Yep.
Because I just believe in trying to put the money back into our community as much as we can.
Right.
So, and I don't live in China.
Right. Nope.
I live over here. Might go vacation in China one day. And I'll put that money in China.
But you live here.
But I live here. So,
all right.
So that was our whole thing, was being able to put the money back into our community and blah, blah, blah. So, that's why we didn't want, because I could have easily gone and bought the same brush off of Alibaba
and just offered it
and
on
just
the site
and sold it on
done.
The site. Yep. But I was like, no, I feel like I would be able to do a greater good if we manufacture the brush, then the manufacture the brush here in the United States, and then the people who are selling it, because there's other people that were retailing her brush too.
Yeah.
We could private label it for them,
mm-hmm.
but she would be the flagship brush because she's the one
mm-hmm.
who, you know.
Well, but the thing is, you had a vision, and it happens within business, right? Everybody's not able to see what you see,
mm-hmm.
And it just happened to be that at that time, she couldn't see. It wasn't meant to be. The timing was not meant to be for that to be a collaboration.
Right.
And so.
So
here we are.
Like I said, right. Here we are. So she turned us down. That's what was coming earlier. Excuse me. And that just decided to show up.
Edit that part out, right?
Right. So we're going to edit that part out. So she turned us down. We're, you know, forging forward because mm-hmm. we decided this is going to be our next big product that we are launching as a Puff Cuff product, another made in the United States, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So if you guys haven't seen the amazing video that we put out about the TangleMaster.
It's really nice. So where can they find it? The video? Are you going to hold for a moment?
On YouTube. Right. We'll hold for a moment.
Moment of silence.
All we right. are TangleMaster. Basic, if you love America, you love TangleMaster. We're not making America great again. We're just loving TangleMaster. Because America is already great. But anyway, yes. So we launched.
Mm-hmm.
And we launched it on Cyber Monday.
Cyber Monday?
Cyber Monday, the video went live. We teased it a little bit. It was very awesomely received. It was awesomely received by the public. And there was some, our fans, and there was some people like, this looks exactly like, yes and no, it doesn't look exactly like the Felicia Leatherwood brush. It functions exactly the same, but we decided to change the shape of the handle, mainly because we were like,
more
comfortable in the hand.
More ergonomic.
Right. Ergonomically designed. Right. So we ergonomically designed our handle because we control everything when it comes to this tooling. So we were able to make little design tweaks, little design changes in order to
like the upper edge.
Right. So our top is round, which that's round to mimic the puff cuff.
Mm-hmm.
Round.
Okay.
And so that's basically it. But so we are the brush right now, we are still they're coming off the press,
mm-hmm.
as we speak.
Yeah.
We will The brush, I'm trying to decide if we're going to do a pre-sale or not. So we did an exclusive offer for Cyber Monday through Cyber Wednesday, which was if you spend $50 on the site,
yeah.
then you get a TangleMaster for free. We are estimating the time frame for us to be able to ship out those free TangleMasters is 12/27, right after Christmas. I'm wondering, should we do a pre-sale? Pre-sales scare my husband. I kind of think we should.
Well, okay. It could be a pre-sale with a very clear caveat that based on supply levels, right? Something, I mean, we said it before.
We have a limited supply of these brushes.
And when we get to that number.
But it's not a limited supply forever. Let's get that straight.
Right.
It's just our first run.
It's the first run.
So, but I kind of want
because there are already people
asking about asking it. When is it going to be for sale? I want it done. Blah 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 blah. Yeah. So the brush retails for $12.99, mm-hmm. on the website, and on our website, thepuffcuff.com. It will also be available on Amazon, and it will also be available on Lord Jesus.
Oh no, she went into prayer. What you about to say?
Please let Sally Beauty.
No.
Want to carry the TangleMaster alongside the Puff Cuff, mm-hmm. in every retail store across this nation, this lovely nation of yours, and overseas, and Mexico, and United Kingdom. Where else they got stores?
All
5,000 of their retail stores and SallyBeauty.com. So hopefully it'll be on Amen.
Amen.
Hopefully it will be on Sally too. We introduced it to them at the Executive Summit in Las Vegas this past November. So they do know about it. And then we will also be offering it as a private label. So if any of you all want your logo right here on the back, and you want your own color and your own version of the TangleMaster, hit us up because it will be offered but via private label too.
How to hit us up at? Where? What's the email address?
You want to get those emails? I don't.
Just go to the info@thepuffcuff.com.
That comes to me. So
or customer service.
Yes. Customer service at thepuffcuff.com. But no, they should talk to one of us. Wouldn't they? Is this eventually going to be forwarded to us?
Initially,
yes.
Customer
if you want to consider private labeling the brush, email us at info@thepuffcuff.com and we can get you out a quote. But private labeling will not be available until after February of 2020.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good job. Good job.
We still have another segment?
We have
one more segment. Okay.
Take us out.
So we will wrap up. Thank you. We will wrap up talking about the TangleMaster.
Yes, the Tangle Master. With sound
Master
effects and
your
everything.
Tangles, yes. We will finish talking about this when we get back from the break. From Idea to Invention with Ceata and Garrett Lash.
What makes America? You. Me. Every freckle. Every career, every smile, every tear. Each family, each friend. It builds and makes us who we are. One community. Every boy, every girl. Each kink. Each curl. We wouldn't change a thing. Because this is who we are. It's our differences and our similarities, our passions and our fears. These are the things that keep us. These are the things that make America. Us. Our curls make us. We are America. We make TangleMaster.
Hey everybody. This is Garrett and Ceata with Idea to Invention. Coming back to you to talk about and finish out, close out our conversation around the TangleMaster.
Right, which is rolling us into
2020.
Yes.
2020. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I got a question for you, Ceata.
Oh, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Me?
Ceata.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see Ceata up in this
That's
face.
How you phonetically say it.
Well, so what's the big deal about an old brush, right? I mean, as we were talking, right, we know that there's other people making this kind of a brush, this equine brush. How will our brush help, right? How will it help the person?
So all of these brushes, in all honesty, they just literally cut your detangling time like in a third, not even in half.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about you can wash and go and detangle.
Yeah.
You can wash, detangle, and go before work in the morning.
So is it really, I mean.
I just did it today, which you just knew I was not going to be able to get downstairs on time. When you saw that I started washing my hair, you were like, oh, crap.
I did say, oh, crap.
Right, didn't you? Because you were like, we told Whitney and I, we're going to be
on time.
And she is wetting her whole head.
Knowing darn well how long it takes.
To detangle.
To deal with all that.
Right. So, not only did I detangle it.
Yeah.
I detangled it and I shot a movie detangling it again.
Didn't.
Yes, I did.
What you say?
And still got here 30 minutes late. No.
Hey, better than an hour late.
No, we had a window of time. Whitney knows when Whitney knows when we say
no,
10.
Ceata time, that's what that is.
Right, the window of Ceata time. Whitney knows if you say 10, she's not going to be here till 10:30. And that's still early.
Lord bless you.
So, but no, I was able to detangle in the shower.
Yeah.
And detangle again because I've been test driving this all weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Detangle again and shoot a video with it.
Yeah.
So, and do a full face of makeup.
So, okay. So it speeds up your maintenance routine.
Yes.
Loosens the toughest tangles you got. Delicately. It doesn't ruin
your... It doesn't rip through your hair.
It doesn't rip through your hair.
No, not at all. But you have to use it properly.
So let's talk about how that
works.
Yeah. Get, okay. Just a real talk through quickly.
So my hair's not wet, so I'm not going
to
do it.
No, I want you to do that.
Because you know, don't manipulate your hair unless it's damp. Unless it's got moisture.
Moisture.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So.
And fellas, you can use it too, because I used it as well. And it works. Yes. It does work very, very well.
Yes.
So just one look.
Because Puff Cuff Male will have its own TangleMaster, but it'll be black.
Ooh, look at that girl. See, we on the same page, y'all. 24 years
like
in.
Like I said, you can get in whatever curl you want. But so the way to detangle, the way, like I said, how I found out the proper way to use this brush, and I'll say, I'm not going to say proper versus improper. I'm saying the most effective way to use the brush is to brush it vertically.
To utilize the whole face of the brush.
All of the times.
Gotcha.
If you brush down. Now, it's awkward because we've all been taught to do this.
Mm-hmm.
But if you use it like this, it's like butter.
Like cutting butter.
Like butter.
What?
I mean, it's just like whoop, whoop.
If it makes that sound.
It does. Whoop, whoop.
Lord.
And then you're done and you're like, wait a second. I still got time to actually eat breakfast and wear my hair, you know, big. And then it really defines your curl. Like if I had more product in it, it would really like seriously define my curls.
Yeah.
And the thing is, you don't leave with a lot of hair in the brush. But when you go this way, it kind of jams all the tangles down here.
Yeah.
When you go like this, so you'll end up detangling and then you'll have a jam of tangles at the bottom. But if you go like this, then it more utilizes all of the tines so they can do the job that they're supposed to. And it's flexing back and forth as well as
side to side.
There you go.
Okay.
That one hurt too. But it's just an amazing, I mean, whoever
invented
the equine brush, they knew what they were doing. And, you know, kudos to Felicia for bringing it to the point where, you know what, this needs to be a brush for curly hair, because it was her genius that put the two together. So,
and that's one thing I wanted to make sure that it's clear, because some would say,
it's a knockoff, or
you're hurting another black brand or another woman brand, and that is not nowhere near the case. As you can hear,
or the intention, not at all.
And you can hear from the conversation of what led up to Puff Cuff producing the TangleMaster, and that all options were put on the table for everyone to benefit. But what it does do for Puff Cuff, it begins to launch us into 2020, going in on a very high note,
an exciting
thing, because you know we've had a year in 2019 that had us at Curl Fest in Atlanta, which was an awesome experience.
We got you, fam.
We had a fabulous time at Sally Beauty's Leadership Summit and Beauty Walk, culminating a year of our first year of partnership with Sally Beauty and going into the second year,
Sally.
Right? And trying to build that relationship in 2019. We've had the fabulous opportunity of conversating and
we went to Paris
and speaking with and one of our bucket list folks, Tristan Walker,
right? We were at Natural Hair Academy in
Natural
Paris,
Academy, and becoming part of RCIE and
yes.
the Natural Hair Academy in France.
I got to speak to Richelieu Dennis. Two bucket list items.
So 2019 has been a full year, and we've been working and humping and hustling and pushing things out. And now with this new product and expanding, 2020 is going to be a year that only God knows how big and powerful it is. And we're always here about building up people and building up businesses and building up small businesses and providing that avenue of information and intellect that is needed by small businesses. And so Eye to Eye and Puff Cuff is here. Here for you, here for the small business, here for the entrepreneur to progress and move our community forward in all avenues and never to tear each other down. So understand, we want you all to always be blessed,
Take care.
Be blessed.
Oh my way.
And be a blessing in everything you do.
Everything.
You. God bless. Have a blessed 2019 and see you in 2020.
See you in 2020.
Peace.
Oh.